SpaceX, which is making affordable reusable rockets, while European Space Agency, on the other hand, has been spending billions of dollars behind Ariane 6, for the last 9 years, and now it has turns out to be disaster for Europe Space Agency. In this video we are going to look at, why is Europe developing a rocket, that costs more than a Falcon 9? After much political wrangling among Germany, France, and Italy, the member governments of the European Space Agency, formally decided to move ahead with development of the Ariane 6 rocket, in December 2014. A replacement rocket for the Ariane 5 was needed, European ministers decided, because of cost pressure from commercial upstarts, like SpaceX and its Falcon 9 rocket. With the design of the Ariane 6, they envisioned a modernized version of the previous rocket, optimized for cost. Because Ariane 6 would use a modified Vulcain engine, and other components from previous Ariane rockets, it was anticipated that the new rocket would debut in 2020. European space policy, however, is every bit as political as that of the United States, if not more so. Member nations of Europe make financial allocations to the European Space Agency, and expect roughly that amount of money in return, in terms of space projects. So the development and production of Ariane 6 was spread across a number of nations, under management of a large conglomerate, France-based ArianeGroup. Parochial politics. This approach combined the worst of the parochial politics that guide NASA funding in the United States, with the sluggish activity of a traditional aerospace company, accustomed to guaranteed contracts. Naturally, therefore, development of the project has lagged and gone over budget. As of this writing, the public date for the debut launch of Ariane 6 remains late 2023, but the rocket's first flight will certainly slip into 2024. And its development budget has nearly doubled, to $4.4 billion. That is a lot of time, nearly a decade, and money for Europe to develop what is essentially a poorer version of SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. In the 9 years, since Europe began development of the Ariane 6 to compete with SpaceX, the Falcon 9 rocket has nearly doubled its payload capacity, and become partially reusable, so it is now more capable and costs far less. It has also launched more than 215 times, which is nearly as many rockets as the Ariane program has launched since 1979. Because of this, the Falcon 9 is now extremely reliable and capable of launching on schedule. So why is Europe developing a rocket that costs more than a Falcon 9 and is a decade late to the party? Because European nations desire independent access to space. This means that European nations can have their own way of putting their most valuable military and scientific satellites into space, without having to rely on NASA, Russia, or the whims of American billionaires. This is a justifiable decision in light of geopolitical events that have cut off Europe's access to the Russian Soyuz rocket. But the Ariane 6 rocket is now failing even at this, its most basic and important task. Politico reports that the European Commission, the executive arm of the European Union, is looking to buy rides on the Falcon 9 rocket, due to ongoing delays in readiness of the Ariane 6 rocket. Previously, the European Commission has booked 6 launches on the Ariane 6 rocket to launch Galileo satellites. 2 in 2017 and an additional 4 in 2020, each carrying 2 satellites. Under the current plan, 3 of these missions are supposed to launch in 2023. There is no chance of that, of course. The first of these Galileo flights will not take place until after the debut flight of the Ariane 6, so likely not before the second half of 2024 at the earliest. In a draft request to EU countries seen by Politico, the Commission is planning to ask for a green light to negotiate an ad hoc security agreement with the US for its rocket companies to exceptionally launch Galileo satellites. The Commission reckons only SpaceX's Falcon 9 heavy launcher and United Launch Alliance's Vulcan system are up to the job of sending the EU's new geo-navigation Galileo satellites, which weigh around 700 kilograms each, into orbit. Seeking US help to keep its flagship space program running puts a dent in the EU's idea of strategic autonomy. Galileo is a point of pride for the EU, as it seeks to become less dependent on other regions for critical infrastructure, services and technology, a quest strongly backed by Paris. The EU is having to seek assistance to launch new versions of its navigation satellites. Because the Ariane 5 rocket, developed by France-based ArianeGroup, and launched from France's South American spaceport, in French Guiana, is to be retired in the next months. The deployment of its replacement, Ariane 6, has been delayed. The new system is currently expected to carry out a maiden launch, at the end of this year, with full commercial deployment starting next year. The alternative to the Ariane series would have been launching Galileo satellites, with Russian-built Soyuz rockets, a version of which are also used at the French Guiana site. However, since Russia's invasion of Ukraine, two Galileo launches using Soyuz rockets have been cancelled, prompting the search for alternatives. Galileo satellites beam highly accurate navigation and precise time data back to Earth, and also provide a top-secret encrypted service for use by government agencies. That means, launches typically can only be carried out from EU territory, under tight security rules. In view of the security-sensitive information included in Galileo satellites, an ad hoc legally binding security agreement with the US is necessary. In order to protect the integrity of the satellites and the Galileo constellation, said part of a draft proposal from the Commission seen by Politico. Apparently, the European Commission has seen enough Ariane 6 delays. The two US rockets capable of picking up the slack, from a technical standpoint, are SpaceX's Falcon 9, and United Launch Alliance's Vulcain rocket. The problem for Europe is that, Vulcain is also running well behind its development curve. The vehicle's first launch is now planned for no earlier than this summer, and Vulcain has commitments to the US Department of Defense, that will likely preclude taking on new commercial customers, for a few years. That leaves only Falcon 9. For Europe, the optics of this are terrible, of course. Its commissioners created the Ariane 6 to compete with SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. Now, a decade later, officials from the continent are going to have to negotiate with SpaceX for a ride to space for some of their most precious satellites. Never mind that the cost is likely to be lower, and that the Falcon 9 is the most reliable rocket in the world, with the lowest insurance costs. It's a bitter pill to swallow. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.
Your configurations will be commercialized as multi-launch service or MLS. Looking at its equally important facilities and launch complex, the Guiana Space Center or CSG offers ideal conditions for launching any payload to orbit at any time. Located at 5 degrees north latitude, its proximity to the equator provides an extra boost of energy due to the Earth's rotation, a slingshot effect that is greater here than at most other launch sites. The CSG provides modern payload preparation facilities that are recognized for their high quality in the space industry. The facilities are capable of processing several spacecrafts from different customers simultaneously. Designed to support